Do you struggle to access data that lives in a linked record in your Airtable setup? For example, you have information deep into a linked relationship that you want to extract and do something with on another table. Well, that's exactly what we're going to be covering here in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you organize and automate as much of your work life as possible, thanks to the help of no-code tools. The core of getting the most out of no-code tools is leveraging no-code automation, and I've put together a free training that will give you a basic understanding of the fundamentals behind automation. You can check that out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and it will help you start automating all of those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do day in and day out. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of the video here. We're talking about conditional ways to look up and roll up information that lives at a different layer in our database. So let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and take a look at our setup. First and foremost, you'll notice that we have two main tables here. I've got clients and I have orders. Clients are straightforward. There's just a name and we're linking to orders. And then on the orders table, we have the order ID that's being calculated thanks to an auto number field. I also have the linked relationship to client. We store the type of order, so it could be a rush or a standard order. We also have a total and we have a date of the order. Now, what I want to envision here is how can I reach into this linked relationship between clients and orders and access some information, specifically the order total, do something with that information based on certain conditions. So maybe we only want to look at the total in the case that we have a certain type of order, or maybe we only want to look at the total in the case where it's the most recent order. How can we utilize lookup and rollup fields in Airtable to help us achieve these goals? So let's first start by understanding what a rollup and lookup field is. A lookup field is going to allow us to look from this table into our linked relationship to orders here and bring back certain information. A rollup field works just like a lookup field, with the exception that we can also do some sort of aggregation function to the information we get back. Now that seems a little nebulous, so let's actually look at a live example of it. First and foremost, let's use a rollup field to bring back the total number of all orders. So I'll name this field total orders amount. And then down here in the field type, I choose rollup. So I find that here and I'm looking at a linked relationship to our orders table. If I had multiple different linked tables here, I would see them listed here, but I only have the one. So I pick orders and now I'm looking at the order total field. So once I've made that selection, I'm now able to take the data that lives in the order total and perform some sort of aggregation formula to it. In this case, I just want to sum that information. As I start typing up SUM, it gives me the actual formula sum parentheses values, and I make that selection here. I can go over to formatting to make sure that my format is showing up in a currency, which it is. And then once I'm good with these settings, I create the field. So what this is doing is accessing all of those three different orders that I have linked to my Acme client here, looking at the order total for those three, 5,000, 6,000, 8,000, summing them up, which we know is 19,000, but putting that number back on the client's table. Pretty cool feature. Now I can take this a level deeper by using conditional actions inside of my rollup as well. So here I might say, I just want to know what the order total is for rush orders. So I'll say rush order total, and again, I'll use that rollup field type. I look again at my orders table, and I choose the field again to be my order total. Just as before, I want to bring back the summation of these orders, so I look up for sum values again. But the difference here is I'm going to toggle on that I only want to include linked records that meet certain conditions. So once I make this toggle, I can apply a filter that says only consider these records that you're finding in the order table. So for example, this is rush orders. So I can easily come in and say, I want to look at the type of order and I want to make sure that I'm only rolling up where we have rush orders. Just like that, I can add as many different conditions to this rollup formula as I would like. But bear in mind that whatever is filtered out is not going to be considered in this total that I'm summing. Once you're happy with this, go ahead and create the field. As I've done, you'll see that this order total is now significantly less than this one. If we go back into our orders table and we take a look, we have one at 5,000 and a second at 8,000, which again is how we're calculating the 13,000 that you saw back on the other table. I'm only including these two because they have the type of rush order. If I make a change to the type and I remove one of these and change it to a standard order, for example, that's going to then change what we have calculated on our other table. Now we only have the one rush order at 5,000. Going back to clients now, we see the 5,000 showing up for Acme client. So this is a great way for you to only bring back certain information that you want from a linked relationship. Here I have a link to three different things, but I'm only summing the ones that meet my specific conditions. Now, one other way that you might want to look at some sort of lookup or rollup, very often folks will want to see the most recent thing that has been linked in. And so, for example, here we have these three orders again. Going back to orders, we have a date for all of them. And we want to only bring back, let's say, the information for the most recent date. That is the one that has occurred most recently. In this case, I've got some back in October, so the most recent one is the one that's actually showing up as an order for November. So how do we do this? If we go back into our clients table and we look at the options here inside of our previously built conditional rollup field, you'll notice that I don't have the option to include something for the date being the most recent. Yes, I can access the date field and build a filter around it, but I can't say is most recent or is max. There's no way for me to say that it is the biggest of all of the dates in there. So unfortunately, the standard filter inside the rollup doesn't work. And this requires us to get a little more thoughtful about how we're going to build this new field. So let's take it one step at a time. Before we build this new field that's going to look up that information and bring back our most recently placed order, first we need to start by calculating the max date of all the dates that live in our order table based on that linked relationship. So we're going to start with max date, and I'll just call it that. Now for this, I will look up a rollup field. So let's go with rollup here. And I'm going to look not at the total that I have here, but in fact, I'm looking at the date field first, the date of these orders. And I can use the max values function here to bring back the biggest date that we find back on that other table. So here I see that 11-1. That was my order placed in November, which I know is the most recently placed order of the three that are linked to this Acme client. Now I can go back to my orders table and look up the max date. So back here, I'll create that max date field and use a lookup field. This time, I'm looking at the linked relationship back to client, and I'm going to choose the field here, max date. Now, this is going to only bring back one date in every case, because there is only one date that can be the max that we found for this client. So in this case, that date was 11-1. So of the three dates here, that biggest date is found on the rollup field at the client level, and then we look it back up to the order table here. Now what I need to do is compare these dates. The actual date of the order, which is this field, compare it to the max date for this particular client to find if it is in fact the most recent order. So I'll build a field here and we'll call it recent order question mark, and I'll use a formula field. And what I'm checking is to see if there is equivalence between my two date fields here. So if there is equivalence between my date field equal to my max date field, that is to say, if my date here in this field is equal to this field here that is the biggest of these dates, in that case, I want to return the order total, for example. So we'll go ahead and find the order total here. My if function can take three different parameters. I have my logical equivalence here. My date is equal to the max date. If it's true, I will bring back this information, which is my order total. If it's not true, I'll bring back whatever my third parameter is. In this case, I don't want anything to be brought back, so I will leave it blank, and I won't install a third section to this formula. Once I'm good with this, I create the field, and you'll notice that what I'm getting is only data back where the date here matches the max date that we found. Before moving on, I want to actually format this to be a currency, not just a number. So I'll go back into this, go to my formatting, change it over to currency, and resave this particular field, and now I'm happy with it. I'm only seeing that order information if it is the most recently placed order. I can hide these fields. The max date doesn't need to show up here. The recent order doesn't need to show up here. But I want that information back at my clients table. So you'll see that now I've built a number of fields just to come up with this one calculation that I'm trying to bring in. So now that I have information on those orders, I can add this field and I can say, this is my recent order amount. And I look it up one more time from our orders table. And I scroll on down to my recent order that I just calculated and I can create this field. Now what I'm gonna see is the dollar amount for the most recent order based on the logic that we've built in here. First, we calculate which order has most recently been placed. That was the order on 11/1. Then back on the orders table, we look up to see which that max date is and we bring it back. And then we're gonna run some equivalence testing and see which of these orders is the most recent. And then we bring that information back yet one more time. So yes, a number of different steps are required here, but this is the best way to bring in information for that most recent order. Let's actually test this out and make sure that everything is calculating appropriately. I can also hide my max date field. I don't need that here. Let's go in and add some more orders back to our orders table for this Acme client. I'll create another rush order, and this will be in the amount of $10,000. And this one will be on the date of 11/4. And you'll see that I also have set this to be sorted, so it's automatically gonna bring that order up to the top. And we'll add one more order as well. This will be a standard order in the amount of 2,500. And I'll make this one set for 11/6. Give Airtable a moment to think. It's gonna reorder those pieces. And now I have five different orders here with a total of 31,500. We can also look and see that our rush order total is 10 and 5, so 15,000 here. And our most recently placed order is the one that came on 11/6, and that was in the amount of 2,500. So we can now swing on back over to our clients table, and that is the information we will see in these three fields. Here's our total. This is summing all of the orders that have been linked to this Acme client. Here's our rush order total. This is only summing the two orders that were coming in with a rush status, which we know to be 15K. And then our most recent order amount was the one that was placed just yesterday in this fictitious example in the amount of 2,500. So using rollup and lookup fields, we have been able to look up conditional information and bring back just the numbers that we want for these different orders. I know we went fast in this video. I hope it wasn't overwhelming, but feel free to go back and watch it again and drop any questions you might have below. Of course, if you haven't already, do subscribe to the channel if you want to stay on top of no-code news and see more videos like this, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.